Nestle Mokambo, but they've not put the Nescafe cafe logo on this, which makes me research just completely useless now. I can't believe I have just wasted 15 minutes research.
If you want a good laugh at badly dubbed, really cheesy or sickly loved up love story, you got to look up the old Nescafe adverts from the UK in the 1980s. You got Sarah Green running around to random people's houses and locations with a random handful of coffee beans for that rich coffee taste and aroma. And then they just disappear. But not disappear like some sort of futuristic technological advancement in camera work. No, they just disappear as if she never held them, just really badly edited as well. Then you got the love story of the man at the door. Nescafe. Am I coming in to a house? Thanks, Brian. Anyway, this is meant to be a review of Nestle Mokambo, or Nestle, or Nestle, however you like to pronounce it. It's weird, isn't it, how things change over the years and the pronunciation of things. No added sugars, it says. Now, Nestle make a lot of cereals, so someone at the boardroom of Nestle has gone, we sell a lot of coffee. What's Nestle again? I forgot where it's from. Nestle. Dutch, isn't it? Is it Dutch? I can't do a Dutch accent. Yeah, so anyway, they were sat at the boardroom and thought, we sell a lot of coffee, we sell a lot of cereal, let's put them together! And we're gonna see now what this tastes like, and we're also gonna see if it velvetizes. And we're gonna see if it tastes any better if you just heat it with some milk. Enough yakety yak yak yak. There's loads and loads of other cheesy adverts from Nescafe as well. But one of them, which I couldn't find in my research, all done on YouTube, obviously, I wasn't going to go super duper mad on research. There was a song and it went something like, Nescafe, Nescafe, your day, something like that. I was about to smell it and I've not broken the seal yet. What is this, Mokambo? Cereals and coffee. Serving suggestion, really difficult to do. I got it from bargain buys for £1, I believe. Put 2 spoonfuls for g of Mokambo in a cup. Add hot milk or water. And mix, that means if I can add hot milk, it should velvetize. So I'm looking forward to this. Nestle Portugal, this one's manufactured in. So, soluble mix with 20% soluble coffee. I can talk. Let's sniff it together, shall we? Let's sniff up together. Are you together? Let's do it together. It smells very... Well, no need for future YouTube, because it actually smells of nothing. So unless your laptop, computer, phone smells of something, you shouldn't be able to smell anything. That is really weird. Enough yakety yak and sniffity sniff. Let's get meckety meckin. I'm going to follow the rules, and it does say put 2 spoonfuls for g of Mokambo in a cup, add hot water and milk, and mix, not stir. And I love the word mix. I don't know why, I just do. So, what's it, 1 to 2 teaspoons? That's a lot, isn't it? So, there's 1 teaspoon, 1 tsp, and 2 tsps. Right. Oh, go back on lid, stupid. Oh, that's annoying, the lid's not gone on straight. Well, it's a good job I'm not OCD, isn't it? That's stupid. What a stupid lid! Anyway. Right, I might as well get the velvetizer out of the cupboard, because it's been in the cupboard for a while, because I've not done a velvetizer video for a while, have I? And if you don't know what the velvetizer is, if you're new to my channel, it's this thing I got from a chocolate shop that I used to wear. It's this thing. You see, normally I would put Canderels in this. Oh, and this is not sponsored by anybody like Nestle or Canderel
or the chocolate shop that I used to work in. Neither is it sponsored by Co-op, which is where the milk is from. It's just me and my money. Oh, I've left my foil on. I like to put the foil back in that because I think it makes a difference. Is it just me who does that? Because I think it makes a better seal on there. Do you know that when it's done, my eyes become wider. There we are. I've got a feeling this is just going to taste a lot like really bad quality coffee. You know when you get a really cheap, nasty, shop-owned brand coffee? Or really off-brand coffee from some random startup company that's just, I don't know, discovered a load of coffee. And so, oh, let's make some coffee out of it and sell it for 99 pence a jar. And we'll see if anyone's stupid enough to buy it. But I feel that's what it's going to taste like.
Ooh. It's developed a smell during brewing. The smell of that. It just smells like a really nasty cup of coffee, to be honest with you. Oh, it is. It's just bad coffee. It really, it's. Oh, hiya. Do you want a really bad cup of coffee?
No, you didn't drop them off, did you? She's just contacting me again.
Always a drama. You see, that kind of drama would sell coffee. Okay, it would. Anyway. Bad, yeah, it'd sell bad. That just tastes really vile. I'm going to have to see if it velvetises now. I'm going to have 2 cups of this nonsense. Yeah, just tastes like a really naff coffee. Not quite as biscuity as sometimes bad coffee can taste like. But it's somewhere between that and blandness. It's really bizarre. I'd have turned this on. And we'll go. So it says 2 spoonfuls, doesn't it? And this makes a cup, so that's 1. And that is 2. Has the lid gone the correct way this... Oh, the lid's gone on correctly this time. That's good. I know you like to see this working, so I'm going to try and pull it forward. I've got it caught under the light. Never mind. Oh, it's starting to go some sort of yellow colour. That's a bit bizarre. It stopped working. Why is it not working? When it does this. Oh, hang on, let's see if I can get this working. Piece of tat. If you're wondering if it was me who broke it, no, but this bit had just randomly got stuck. This had got stuck to the little metal-y bit. So that was stupid. So now it should work. There we go. There we go. Now it's working. Yeah, you gargling mix. Piece of crap. And there was me thinking it was built to last because it was made by Dewlett. Come on, mixy, mixy, mixy. Don't take that long, actually. And we'll see if it velvetises better than it does with hot water. It might taste better with milk, because cereal does taste better with milk rather than water. Maybe this is more cereal-y rather than coffee-y. Cereals and coffee, though. And in the ingredients, it says nothing. There's no ingredients at all, in fact. It just says cereals and coffee. Very, very, very bizarre. Well, I'm going to keep on yakking whilst it's doing that. And whilst it's doing that, I'm going to put in a canderel and see if I can drink the rest of this without doing myself any injury. What's your favourite brand of coffee? Let me know in the comment section down below. What is your favourite coffee? They always seem to do seductiveness when selling coffee, don't they? It's always something like Nescafe, gold blend. Apart from that stupid coffee which you all know that I hate, which is I love Carte Noire. I'm glad they brought that brand back. Carte Noire.
That needs a really good advertising campaign for Carte Noire. Needs something really posh and something really la-di-da. Something like Carte Noire. Because only coffee is good when it's called Carte Noire. What am I doing? What am I saying? I don't know. Does it taste better with Canderel? Yes. It does taste better with a couple of Canderels. I only put two in. Oh, it stopped. Let's get a different cup. Here is a different cup. And we shall see if it velvetizes. Does it Ooh, look at that froth. Ooh, this is good. This is a big mug, by the way, so if you're wondering why there's not... Look, I'm going to scoop out the frothage. Frothage. Oh, that's a nice word, isn't it? Frothage. Sounds like some of those short-tongued cats say sausage. Frothage. Still quite a lot of frothage in there. Oh, that. Oh, I love that word, frothage. Are you into frothage? That's because it sounds quite sexual, doesn't it? Now that I've said it, it sounds really dirty. Are you into frothage? I like a bit of frothage. I'm talking about the coffee now, and I'm trying to do it with a coffee seductive voice. Try this new Nescafe Mokambo with perfect frothage. Maybe the frothage gives it that extra taste of seductiveness. Still smells like crap. No, it doesn't taste good. Where's my Canderel? Canderel. Canderel. Right, this is only a small cup, so I can only put three in. Which is lies, I'd normally put five or four in or something. Right, it's a give it a good mix, as it suggests, but I don't want to get rid of the froth. You know, will I buy this stuff again? No. Are they taking some kind of piss with this, actually? Because it doesn't actually... Yeah. It's not good. I don't reckon that. I don't recommend you buy Mokambo. They've registered trademarked it, so it's not as if it's some kind of coffee drink that they have in Portugal. Are you from Portugal? Let me know. Have you been to Portugal? I know they did a very distasteful joke about a family left a kid out there. Just... Oh, offensive. Oh, if you get offended by things like that, I think we all know what, well, we don't all know for sure, but we've all got a pretty good idea, haven't we? Has Mokambo turned me mad? I think it has. I've gone mad on Mokambo. It's crap. It really is. Do not buy it. If you see it, I don't even know what kind of other uses you could possibly do for this. I mean, I've tried velvetising it, and I've tried making it as it's supposed to be done, but no. Anyway, please scratch that one in the comment section down below. Do you love Mokambo? Is that how you pronounce it? It's probably pronounced completely different. Maybe you don't pronounce the O's in it, so it's just Mokambo. 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 Maybe you don't pronounce the cam, maybe it's just... What am I doing? Was this even a review? What have you just spent your time wasting on right now? And what time have you watched this? That's a good thing, actually. I never said that before. What time are you watching this now? Are you watching it in bed? Have you just randomly discovered this and thought, who the hell is this with a blue background and a blue t-shirt? What's a velvetizer? What country is this bloke from? Well, I'm from England. And it's quite normal to believe me. He lied whilst laughing. What is wrong with me? I've gone mad. Maybe this is madness in a jar. I feel really weird.
It's the I really do, actually. As the caffeine in this, like, really, like... It says, contains naturally occurring sugars. No added sugar, it says. What's in this stuff? I've gone mad. Maybe it's not crap after all. Maybe we're going to find people walking around and burning it on spoons and sucking it through a straw or something. And I don't know. I'm going now. Bye.